श्री मिथुन रेड्डी जी,
थैंक यू मैम. एट द आउटसेट आई'ड लाइक टू थैंक यू फॉर परमिटिंग मी टू टॉक ऑन दिस इंटर स्टेट रिवर वाटर डिस्प्यूट अमेंडमेंट बिल 2017. एज वी ऑल नो, वाटर इज अ वेरी प्रीशियस थिंग एंड द होल थिंग, आई मीन एवरीथिंग इज रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड वाटर इन आवर कंट्री राइट नाउ. So this bill is very important for the country and more so for my state. And if you see everything, including the economy, including the politics, or everything is dependent on this. I'd like to give an example also how acute this water crisis is. In my constituency, there is a peculiar problem. The girls are not willing to get married into my constituency because it's drought prone, and parents don't want to send their daughters to such drought-prone areas. Such is the importance of water. So if you see, almost 65% of our country is dependent on agriculture, and effective management of water is the need of the hour. And providing livelihood to almost 65% of the population depends on effective water management. So it is very important issue what we are discussing today. And even Niti Aayog, in its report, has stated that one of the major problems the country is going to face is drinking water. And drinking water, if it's a problem for us, how are we going to progress? Because water is a basic thing. So, the more so ever, I request the Honorable Minister to consider the effects of climate change. Because this is an age-old act which was done in 2017, the amendment was done in 2017, but the scenario is changing every year, and the effects of climate change are devastating. I'll quote an example. If you see, for example, the city of Chennai, recently we have seen heavy rains where Chennai was flooded and the people used boats to go, and more recently we have seen that they are transporting drinking water in tankers, in railway wagons to Chennai. So this is the pathetic situation if you don't manage water properly. And especially our state of Andhra Pradesh, the problem is really, really acute. We have issues with Godavari River Basin, we have issues with Krishna, we have issues with Vamsadhara. So we need timely resolution for all these problems. So this bill states that the first step of resolving this issue is negotiations. Ma'am, I would like to bring to your notice that negotiations are only possible when the leaders are magnanimous, when they have a heart of gold, and when they are committed, when they see the larger picture more than the petty politics of interstate disputes. So, for example, recently our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri Jagan Mohan Reddy, and the Honorable Chief Minister, KCR, they went forward, they moved forward, they showed that they are magnanimous, and they showed that they have a heart of gold, and they could resolve the issues in 2 days. But it was not the case in the earlier governments. We had a lot of disputes. It was so bad that one of the in Srisalam Reservoir, both the staff of both the states, they almost came into blows regarding sharing of water. So I request the minister to relook at the whole thing, because this is a very progressive bill. This is the need of the hour for the country. And if you see, like, a dispute resolution committee, we are okay with the dispute resolution committee, and we are okay with the composition or with the whoever is being constituted in the committee. But what we suggest is that they should be acceptable by both the affected parties. And if you see, the one lacuna in this dispute resolution committee is that they have given a period of 1 year and 6 months. So 1 year and 6 months is too long a period, because the farmers, the crop, the tenure of the crop is three months to 4 months. So 1.5 year is too long a period. We have the data. Data is monitored on a daily basis. We have what has happened for the past 50 years. We don't need 1 year and 6 months. We are like, we need to act fast. I think it should be fixed like 1 month or 2 months, where the whole thing needs to be resolved on a priority basis, on a war footing basis. Because 1 year, 6 months, everybody will be affected. An honorable minister, an honorable member from DMK was stating that once you put this 1.5 year committee, and then it goes for another 2.5 years, then it's 4 years, the whole purpose is lost. I totally agree with that. We need a committee which is time bound. It should be in months. 1 year, 1 year, 6 months, we totally oppose this period of 1 year, 6 months. It should be in at least like 1 or 2 months. because we have the data, there's nothing more we are going to get. When we have the data and when everything is available, we need to resolve it fast. That is our demand. And once it is not possible through the dispute resolution committee, it goes to the Interstate River Water Dispute Tribunal. And this is even worse because there again it is like a period of 2 years and then again extendable by almost 1 year, I think. So this is also too much, madam. I think it should be solved on a war footing basis. Everything should happen within 6 months. This is our demand. We expect the government to take a favorable decision on this. And the data which is going to be maintained, the maintenance of data bank and information. So when we have this data and information, it doesn't serve the purpose that if we drag the time, we take it for years and years. I think it should be decided as soon as possible. And I will tell you a reason for this also, ma'am. The data is very crucial because, for example, in our state, right now, we have floods happening in the Uttarandhra region, and we have also have drought in the same state in one part. So it is because of climate change, we are not able to predict when it's going to rain, when it is going to, when there's going to be a drought. So efficient water management is very, very important, especially the rights of the lower riparian states should be protected, and they should not feel insecure. Whatever it is, we are supporting this bill thoroughly, and we want this bill to be more progressive. We have an issue with this time limit. We want the time limit to be cut down, and we also put our request that the constitution of the members, whoever is going to be, should be amicable for both the affected parties. So thank you, ma'am. Thank you for permitting me to talk on this, and we heartfully support this bill. Thank you very much.